When did it first start? Oh, right. It started from the moment I was born. I want to become a worthy Archon. So I've kept studying, kept listening to my people and their hearts, kept looking for a way to save Ermin's soul. Have I been doing the right thing? The sages are creating a god to replace me. Am I really not needed? It's so quiet here. How do I really feel about all of this? Now that I think of it, I don't think I've ever actually listened to my own inner voice. Do Archons have them? Should Archons have them?
Since you're the god of wisdom, you've known the answers to all these questions since the very beginning, haven't you?
Who are you? Whose voice is that? It sounds familiar.
Are you awake? Or are you sleeping? Are you afraid? We've been waiting for this meeting. Superman, are you with me when I am too weak? Oh, Mother, are you dreaming of me in your sleep?
We have come for you, and we're coming in peace. Mothership will take you on higher, higher. This world you live in is not a place for someone like you. Come on, let us take you home.
It's time to go. You are infected. Come as you are. Don't be scared of us, you'll be protected. I guess you are a different kind of human.
peace, mothership will take you on higher, higher. This world you live in is not a place for someone like you. Come on, let us take you home.
By my appearance?
Did you wake me up? Why are you here?
Ermansoul and the surrounding lands have been reproduced here as they were years ago. But this is just a realm of consciousness. We are manifestations of the same nature. Hence why we would appear exactly the same.
Hmm? We're of the same nature? Why?
Because you are me, and I am you.
If this is true, then am I going to be a great Archon like you someday?
Though we share the same nature, our fates are bound to be different. All things have their own fate. When a branch grows into a mature tree, it won't be the same as the original tree.
That's why fate is the ultimate knowledge, isn't it?
That's a great insight. Yes, very good. It's also precisely why you won't become like me.
Really?
But perhaps you may become an even greater Archon than I. I already see a determination in you that I didn't possess in my time. And the future that it leads you to will be yours alone. Don't worry. The growth of wisdom is like that of a plant. You only need to wait quietly for the flower to bloom. Seeking answers, right? For a long time, I thought dreams were the fruit of human wisdom. Though it was selfish to do so, I borrowed people's dreams using the Akasha. Then I compiled their wisdom and all of my own power. Thanks to the wisdom of the people of Sumeru, almost all the forbidden knowledge was cleared from Ermansul. The important thing was that, even if I died, my existence and everything related to me would continue to exist in Ermansul as memories and knowledge. Meaning that the forbidden knowledge couldn't ever be permanently eradicated. And there's no way for me to eliminate myself. It would be a sort of paradox. So, I took the purest branch of Ermansul as my incarnation in the next samsara, and left a trail of clues, all in hopes that you would come here and remove me and my pollution from Ermansul forever.
Wait! No, I can't! How can we just forget you like this?
You're the god of wisdom, Buur. You should know that there is no other way.
I never grew toward the sun. To the moon I drank the light that filled the sky. I used to think that I was chosen. I could see the stars that burned when they died. But here you found me in the rain, and I can see my true reflections. Butterfly in
completely forget me. great tree of wisdom, peering out to perceive the world. From the earth and from the rain, we perceive its wonders, until we become a white bird to perch atop a branch, and finally snap off the most important leaf. Once upon a time, I alone dreamed in this world. In my dreams, everybody would also dream after they fell asleep. Wild and wonderful thoughts would emerge from their minds. Some tumbled to the ground, and others floated to the sky, connecting all things in the world into one dazzling net. Among a plethora of worlds were numerous smaller worlds, all of fate, finding within the tapestry their brilliant glow. I gradually understood that these indescribable and constantly changing things are the most profound things in the world. Only they can completely repel the madness. Only dreams can awaken consciousness from the deepest darkness.
I was a moving thing before I was a human being. I was the ice before it melts. I was the tree before it fell. My dear, come near. Do you understand what is happening? Crawl beneath the earth to feel the hunger and the thirst. If you could fly and be the bird, then you would see the forest burn. My dear, come near. Do you understand what is happening? Somehow calm within the madness of a storm, with no solution for the scare, tasting pollution in the air. My dear, come near. Do you feel my hand? It is there.
Exhale.
Sought a solution. Saving the world with the dreams of the people used to be my answer. And now, you've also found your own answer, and I shall return all the dreams to the people. Goodbye, people of Sumeru. May you be blessed tonight with the sweetest of dreams.
Thank you.
here.
We're here to rescue you. Are you all right?
I'm fine. It's just, when I think of everything that's happened to me, I feel really angry now.
You should have been angry ages ago.
I won't ignore my own voice anymore. Thank you.